If you are creating a web page with some download links on your website that you would like your visitors to click on, would you rather create a page like this with some download links or with the same content, a page that looks like this? Hello everyone, this is Amit. In this video, we'll learn how we can style links in HTML so that the page will look like this. All right, so let's get started. By the way, just before we start, if you guys haven't subscribed to my channel, please click on the subscribe button on lower right corner. I post new videos about Notepad++, HTML, and many other tips and tricks every week. So make sure that you subscribe to my channel to get the upcoming videos. All right, so let's get started. Okay, so we will start with this very bare minimum basic HTML page with two links. And then we would like to get to this, which has some background images, and then the those two links are changed into buttons. So first we'll convert these two links into more of a square buttons, and then we'll also try to apply some rounded corners, and then we'll add it the text, change some fonts and so on to make it look nice, and then also add the background image. Okay, so the very first thing, if I go back to this simple HTML page, here is the bare minimum HTML page. And then the very first thing we can do is to add a style block in the header. So I'm going to just say style, right? And then we will add different CSS properties into that. And so, by the way, you can also see that as I'm making the changes to this HTML page, you can see those changes are shown right here, previewed in Notepad++, right, without actually opening a browser. And that is because there is a plugin called HTML Previewer or Markdown Previewer. So if you would like to learn about that, I'm going to link a video regarding that right here. So make sure that you check that. For example, if I change to this, you can see that it'll change right on the fly. Now, if you have a really complex CSS property, sometimes it doesn't preview completely, and so you may have to eventually look it into a browser. But at least for a quick changes here and there, you don't have to just make switch back between your Notepad++ and your web browser. By the way, it's very easy to actually open different browser right from Notepad++. You can go to view, and then you can go to view current file, and then it does provide you a multiple browser options to open this file in. So if I click on edge, it should open. It should have opened. I'm not sure why it didn't. Or maybe because there is a space. I should not have put a space in there. Anyways, but you should be able to open these files into different browser. Okay, so let's start with some basic CSS property. All right, so we have added a style tag in here, and then we are going to just give different properties to the hyperlinks. And so the very first thing is going to be, let's say we would like to remove these underlines, and so it'll be text decoration. And then we would like it to be none. And as you can see, it's actually gone. And then let's do background color to be, let's say, black. And then we will color the text of this as white. You can also have any other colors and so on. So, or the hex value, but I'm just using a very simple color names. All right, let's do text alignment. So text align, and that is center, even though it's actually padding right here. So we need to add some padding to this a tag. And so I'll say padding, maybe 15 pixel, and then 25 pixel, right? So that looks much better. And then also, this whole a link is an inline block, Okay, block, block. Okay, so that looks better. And so this is a very simple button that I have created in HTML, right? Okay, so now that we have a basic buttons for these links, and these links are right here, we are going to add a class. So we'll add a two different class. I have already added it right here. And so the first link, I would like it to be rounded buttons. And so just I just had it class equals to rounded buttons. And then the second link I would like to have as a square button. And so I'm adding a class equals to square buttons. Now, instead of applying these CSS property to entire A tag, I can just do apply these properties to a particular class. And so as you can see, since I applied these tag to rounded buttons, the other one didn't make any changes. And so I can copy these. Now you can make it a little more efficient, but just for the demonstration purpose, I'm just going to copy the entire block. And so this one I'm going to call it square button. And you can see that now I have these properties apply to both, and now I can make the changes to colors. So let's say this is blue, and you can see it is making those changes and so on. And maybe this is, let's say, red. Okay. All right. So far we have created these two links. If I view and go to Chrome, wonder why it is not showing. Did I save it? Okay, because I didn't save it. All right, so save and go here and refresh, and you can see those two buttons. And so the next part, what we will do is we will actually add a background image, and that will make this page really, really nice. And so let's go back, and then I'm going to add a body tag, and there is a property called background hyphen image, and then all you need to do is to give a path to the image. And so if I open my folder, I have images folder inside this HTML page, and then inside that I have a mountain.jpg. that is the background image. I mean, we can pick anyone, but I found this to be really nice looking. Now the image should be in a pretty good quality. I mean, it should have a nice at least 1080p, so that it'll look good and it won't pixelize. Okay, so but at the same time, don't make it really big. The size that your HTML page will take a while to load. So there's always a, you know, give and take. But I'm going to use this mountain.jpg under images folder, which is right here. So all I have to do is just give that path, and the way in which you do is just type URL and then dot, which means the current directory, / images, and then mountain.jpg. okay, and if I let's save it and let's refresh this, now you can see that image is showing up. But if you notice, it's actually showing the entire image, and the reason is there are some other properties regarding this image that you need to set up. Now I'm going to quickly add that here, but if you would like to learn about how to add these background images in more details, I'm going to link that right here, and so make sure that you check that video. But I'm just quickly going to type these again. As I said, if you really want to learn more about it, please check that video, which goes into much longer details. Okay, and so I just added an image link. I don't want it to repeat, and I would like it to be covered. And then also the background attachment is fixed. That means when you scroll up and down, the image won't scroll up and down. So I'm going to save this. I'm going to go to the browser and refresh it. And this is how it looks. So this, as you can see, when I zoom up and down, the image itself is not zooming in or out. So let's keep it to 100%. And so now what we are going to do is we'll do some text editing, add some nice color to these buttons. The blue and red are good, but it just doesn't look very professional. And so let's do that actually. And at least in my case, I tested different colors and I found some colors that really goes with this background images. So you can pick and choose. By the way, if you go online and Google the HTML color names, you can even add a hex code, or in my case, I remember there is a color called dark slate gray that I wanted to try. Dark slate gray. So why is it not showing up here? Refresh. Okay, so yeah, that's better. As I said, this preview is pretty handy, but there are times where it doesn't, you know, preview everything, and so that's the reason why it didn't show up completely. And then the other button I would like is golden rod. Okay, so this may be a okay, yeah, so gray works with gray or grey. Somehow our web browser can detect both of them, but somehow these preview plugin didn't detect properly. So anyways, I added two colors, dark slate gray and goldenrod, and then I'm going to save it and I'm going to refresh it, and you will see the difference in the color. So it looks, I think it looks much better with this background image. Now, one thing we forgot is to round these corners for this particular link. And so the rounded corner, there's a CSS property called border radius, I believe. And then you can give the radius value. So I'm going to say 10 pixel. Okay. Oops. Oh, come on. Right. And save. And then refresh. And now you can see it has added nice rounded corner. And so it just looks good. So I just added both the options, however you would like to, you know, apply. Okay. All right. So it looks great, but I'm going to do a few more things to really make it look like this. Okay. And so I'm going to give some new font to the main header or H1 header. And then, so let's try that. So if I go back and then let's say our H1. And I'm going to say font family. And there are a number of pretty neat fonts that you can try in Microsoft, or even there are Google fonts that are really good. But make sure that, you know, you pick the fonts that are available in all systems. So I'm going to call this, there is a called Lucida Grande is the font name, which I believe looks really neat. And then I'm going to align this H1 tag as center. So text align is center. All right. And so let's save this. Let's go to our browser and refresh. Okay. So Lucida Grande. Okay. Okay. And then the font size. Let's put it at 100 pixels or 80 pixels. Okay. Font family. Okay. All right. And then for the P tag, again, these are often trial and error, or according to your own, you know, test, you can change. But I'm going to call this color is black, I mean, which is, should be default. Font family, I would like it to be Arial or sans serif. Okay. And again, text alignment is center, because we want to center all of them. And then font size would be around 20 pixel. Okay. So save. Let's refresh. All right, look at this. Looks amazing. So we started, and I'm going to do some cleaning here. Okay. So by the way, this is the preview also. You can see the preview. I'm going to close this. And so we started with a very simple HTML page, and then we added number of CSS properties to look something like this. So this was what we started with, and this is how it looks. And so I believe that this is way more attractive, and then people will definitely click on the links that you have created. So I hope you guys like this video. I hope you learned a lot of new things. And if you did, please click like button and make sure you subscribe to my channel. I post new videos every week about HTML, about Notepad++, and many other tips and tricks. So please do so.